I excommunicated myself. I dropped out and went elsewhere. Well, that looks pretty rough. Yeah, but at least it's freedom.
GIs returned from World War II with mechanical skills and shell shock. Biker clubs replaced the brotherhood and adrenaline they'd got used to in the military.
These are people that are in a tour of duty. They're actually in combat. What happens is naturally you begin to form bonds through a military system that outlast that system. Your guy who you were in the foxhole with, you can rekindle that or recreate that in a system like a bike club.
I've been riding since 1941. The jacket, I got it back in 65 because I was in the Hell's Angels. Well, we were Levi's. They had to be tough. Just like women, you never give up on them.
Bikers had a look. A Levi's trucker jacket and 501s could withstand the wind, rain, and whatever else the road dealt. It was also a canvas to show their affiliations.
If you're rocking a Harley, of course you're going to have on a pair of salty old crazy Levi's. You got caught in the rain, and the more you wear them, the cooler they get.
In the 50s, young farm workers turned rockers wore their 501s on stage. This juvenile delinquent style led to Levi's being banned in many schools outright.
Troubled kids headed for trouble, with destruction and violence their only outlet.
In 1960, Levi's officially adopted the term jeans, the slang term used by teenagers. Levi's became a rock and roll go-to.
People dressed up to get on stage, and all of a sudden you were like, here you are in the same denims that you were digging your ditches in yesterday. It's almost like a punk move when rock music kind of came to the fore. It had a lot to do with honesty. I think people saw like wearing denim on stage as kind of a symbol of that.
Punk rock to me was jeans, t-shirt, boots, and I had a length of chain for a belt. So because I had to take it off and like brandish it as a weapon. I'm no tough guy, trust me.
I'm very proud of all my record covers. I have some clinkers, but I'm not going to tell you which ones. This is Neil Young. This is After the Gold Rush. They're patched, which was the style. I mean, look at the jean guys, man. Everybody in this photograph are wearing jeans, except the manager and the record producer. Make of that what you will.
It was and still is the garment of the outlaw, the rock and roller, the biker, the punk rocker, and a lot of other cultures that might not be allowed into the White House for dinner.
In the 60s, intellectuals and artists adopted 501s too. Crowds wore them through decades of activist movements, from beats to hippies to LGBTQ rights to the fall of the Berlin Wall.
It was a whole period about saying no, rebelling against things. I've always had a sense of humor about rules. Wearing Levi's was an act of rebellion.
I was a photographer and I did a book on gay fashion from the 70s. The 501s in this culture communicated gayness. There's all these other signifiers. You can add keys. You can have handkerchiefs, put leather chaps over them. Some people would use sandpaper on their jeans in the crotch area.
I got my first pair of 501 blues when I was 12. I saved up my birthday money. I got a size 40, although I was a size 28 waist. 501s, it was synonymous with skateboarding at the time.
I fancied myself as a skinhead or a rude boy, definitely a rockabilly, wrote graffiti, hip-hop culture, the 501 just fit any of them.
Mods and rockers, Beatle freaks, punks and skunks and kooks and geeks, which pretty much sums up Levi's.
Emulating Patti Smith and the Ramones and people who were living like paupers in New York City.
I inherited a pair when I was a kid. My brother was a suede head, like a 2 or number 3 skinhead. The uniform was Doc Martens and 501s.
I had to hide them. I was on my way to rabbinical school and I wasn't supposed to be packing jeans with me.
And they weren't necessarily wearing them for any other reason than they found them or some chick stole her boyfriend's pants.
The 501s are the Australopithecus of cool jeans.
I've been through a lot of different scenes over the time and seen things in life repeat themselves. I can remember a lot of different periods in a long life. Times change, right? But it stays the same. We are pretty simple creatures.